Hello everybody and welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to discover how to run puzzles and survival on your PC. As you can see now, you are able to display it on screen. We will be able to easily download and set up puzzles and survival and enjoy the game on our Windows desktop or laptop with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. First of all mates, to start we need to open our favorite browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to the next URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, simply because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived there on our own site of Usitility, exactly where we have a nice in-depth overview on the best way to download and install puzzles and survival on laptop or computer. We browse down a tad and mouse click on the download game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to this game puzzles and survival on the PC. As you can discover from here, we get some advantages of using this emulator. Then, we are ready to start downloading the puzzles and survival by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. The step is clicking on the button. And the download action takes no time at all. Voila! This is the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the executable file. Okay, so we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We said yes. I reduced the internet browser to start to see the installation software significantly better. The installer is really easy to understand. It is made up of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path actually does. We basically just simply click on it. Therefore we note that we vague got here the path where the emulator is going to be put in. If we prefer to vary this folder we have got to click on that browse option, and now we select another directory and set up the emulator where we desire. To keep it simple, just leave it where it is. I click on back. So I simply click install. Voila! The setup commences and it is going to move forward along with the download of those MB that happens to be represented on our computer screen. Once you save it on your hard disk, it may be a bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed may go faster or at a lower speed, based on your type of connection and according to the velocity of the emulator web servers. Today they are progressing super fast. The download is finished, and so straight away it continues on with the setup part. The setup needs a little bit more or less time based on the strength of your laptop or computer. The more powerful it really is, the shorter the software installation time and vice versa. If we merge the download and installation phase it might take quite a while, so have patience. It is already ended for me. At this point, the emulator happens to be started successfully. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right when it gets into the ending, the emulator is started for the first time. The fact is the emulator was already started, there for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can see now, it created a couple of software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is going to be the only one we're concerned with. When we choose to run puzzles and survival on the PC, we double-click on this app icon and as a result use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything at all like this. Basically, it's an software icon that we would most certainly never make use of. We should perform the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is started. At this point we are required to sign in. At present as soon as we're on this page, we are required to perform this next phase that is definitely imperative. Therefore just click on, sign in. At this point it shows, checking info. It might once in a while get blocked in, checking info, and so it isn't going to proceed. If that's the case, you could attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it may quite likely be corrected. At this point we're going to provide our login name and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. As an example you can utilize the exact same email you are using at the moment in your YouTube account. Therefore I am going to enter my details and I will revisit immediately after I have done it. That's all, details typed. Find out Google welcoming us and providing us their twos. We would say yes to them all by just pressing, I agree. After that, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it selected it's going to make a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize this feature if you like. We mouse click on accept. Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To set up the app, we have got to browse the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking on the app icon marked in green. Today that we are watching the desktop of that emulator for Android, we observe that we come with right here the install app option. We then click on this button. Right here we have got the Android game. Let's press right here on the install link that I am just presenting now in green color. Therefore it will commence the software setup. Presently it should download and install the game app, it typically takes quite some time, or perhaps it might well be extremely fast. This all depends on the internet connection. It has already finished setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by pressing this specific option that I'm showing in green, that allows you to start puzzles and survival for the very first time. Shall we simply click on this My Games Choice proceeding? We're now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're about to mouse click on that fresh puzzles and survival software icon that was provided. This video game is started for the first time on your computer. Currently there we get it, I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the sound level of that emulator. It's right here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of the emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. That is actually the very first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon which I am basically designating in green color. Then the monitor is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. Supposing that we would like to play the application in full screen, we hit this particular application icon. And we'd presently be experiencing and enjoying the video game in 100% screen setting. To escape the complete screen functionality, just click the F11 key. And we'd currently play in regular display setting. At this moment I am choosing to explain you the computer keys mapping that is really rather helpful. That strategy we definitely will be in a position to utilize the video game more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this keyboard icon. And here you will be able to complete the recommended adjustments. Let me put the normal settings, though if you intend to adjust it, you can also do it with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is entirely in our own language. On occasion it happens that your emulator is started in the improper language, such as, in Japanese. Then to place it in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then there throughout many other configurations, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can easily go for the language we need, Italian, Mandarin, and so on. When the language is selected, we would save, the emulator will restart, along with the game, the next time we use it, would as well be in the preferred language. At present, there's another thing that we have to take into account, and it's that we will get an email telling you that a completely new electronic device has been associated with our Google account. It is going to ask us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Yes, we really should not worry, considering that the emulator is behaving like an Android smartphone or tablet. And then to find which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. So we go here to the model selection. And now we notice that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for our video user demo. I believe you enjoyed it, specifically that everyone thought it was informative. If that is so, allow it a great like, subscribe, and if you have comments, concerns or suggestions, leave them in the comment area below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams on occasion, you have it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Click on any of the video tutorials which are usually appearing on the screen and see you in the following instructional videos. Bye.